There is always a Steve Wozniak behind every Steve Jobs. Genius, but lost, underappreciated, or not popular particularly, even if appreciated in a closed circle. History is filled with such unsung heroes in several battles, politics, religion, and science. Their presence has shaped the world. Their theories have motivated the newer generations to move forward. But we do not know enough about them. Today, let us see some of those not popularly known figures in science. My name is Kyle, and you are watching The World of Science. P.C. Vaidya. His name is Prahlad Chunalal Vaidya. Born in 1918, in pre-independence Gujarat, he was one of the prominent figures in the history of modern physics in India. After graduating in physics and majoring in mathematics, he went to Banaras Hindu University to study general relativity, which was quite a popular topic all over the world. The time was 1942, and the Quit India movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi all over India. He was very much motivated by Gandhian philosophy, and he turned into a true and devoted Gandhian in the later part of his life. During this time, he was constantly listening to news on radio about the state of movement, and in parallel, thinking about the theory of relativity and its implication on massive stars. It was during these tough times, he proposed a new solution to relativity that was later named after him, known as Vaidya metric. Schwarzschild metric defines the shape of space and time around a spherical object, but it assumes the exterior of the object to be completely empty. Vaidya calculated the metric for a radiative collapsing star and adjusted the values of radiation coming out of a massive star in his theory. He was just 24 at that time. This was a big achievement and paved the way for future models of black holes. He was one of the pioneers of the golden age of relativity and one of the founders of a prestigious scientific journal, General Relativity and Gravitation. He remained a true Gandhian till his death. He used to wear simple dhoti and used to ride a bicycle on his way to Gujarat University, where he was the chancellor. He is one of the men that every Indian should know about. Nikola Tesla. Okay, today he is not an unsung figure, but before the 90s, he was just another name lost in history books. He was born in Serbia, but later moved to America. He was a genius, and everyone knows about it. He was an electrical engineer, mechanical engineer, and philosopher in his own sense. In India, he is particularly known for his time spent with the great Swami Vivekananda. Nikola was about to demonstrate to him a model to show how matter and force are one and the same thing and can be reduced to potential energy. Sadly, he was unsuccessful, and later Einstein proved that E equals to mc squared. He was a visionary. One of the most talked about dreams of Tesla was wireless electricity and communication, for which he was searching funds to build multiple towers to ensure the flow of inherent electromagnetic charges all around the world through his conducting towers. Sadly, he couldn't manage to get money to fund his projects. His later life was gloomy, and he spent most of his time in his hotel room. Unpaid bills kept on increasing, and there was no one to help him. In his early life, he worked under Thomas Edison and his company, but later left on his own due to some issues, which we all know about. But you do not really need to hate Edison in order to love Tesla. They both were geniuses. Tesla was also a showman, always demonstrating various experiments to celebrities and the rich bourgeois. Tesla was left forgotten, but now he is the motivating factor behind many science enthusiasts, and this is a hope that true talent never goes unnoticed. Hypatia. Her name was a symbol of protest against the Catholic Church during the period of Enlightenment. She was one of the most important figures in the history of science and mathematics, and probably the first female mathematician whose record is well maintained. She was the daughter of mathematician and commentator Theon. Theon is the one whose commentaries of Euclid's Elements survived and are now being taught in school. Like her father, she was brilliant. She belonged to the Hellenic school of Neoplatonism, believing in a higher reality, the one from which this world is generated. She was an astronomer, mathematician, and a professor of philosophy, teaching many pagan and Christian students in Alexandria, Egypt. She edited Ptolemy's Almagest and gave lectures on the theories and principles of Aristotle and Plato. Many consider her as a universal genius. Her commentary on the conic section is still widely regarded and studied. She was the one who focused on the epicyclic motion of planets that later became the basis of the heliocentric model of the solar system. But her end was horrifying. She was punished for blasphemy and murdered and dragged to death in the same street she once roamed. Her revival in the modern age will be the revival of high thinking and freedom. Subrahmanyam Chandrasekhar. He was an Indian-born American physicist. He won the 1983 Nobel Prize for his work on the evolution of stars. He studied at Presidency College, Madras, and later at University of Cambridge. His work involved the study of the theoretical model of massive stars, white dwarf and black holes, stellar structure, general relativity, and quantum theory. He was the second Indian to receive the prestigious Trinity Fellowship, after the great Srinivasan Ramanujan. He studied the structure of stars that are in their last stage of consuming hydrogen fuel. He calculated the mass of the stars that will retain its shape and size due to outward electron degeneracy pressure. This mass limit is called Chandrasekhar limit, that is, 1.4 times the solar mass. The stars that are more massive than the mass limit defined will further collapse into a dense neutron star or a black hole. His theory was a vital step in understanding the nature of the fate of a star. During his period of prominence, he was invited to be involved in the Manhattan Project, but due to delay in security clearance, he could not reach in time. Check out this interesting video about the Manhattan Project. Chandrasekhar is quite remembered in West India, and there are various space observatories named after him, but his name is not that popular in Indian conscience, despite his work being of the same level as that of Stephen Hawking. Emmy Noether. She is considered as the most important woman in the history of mathematics. She revolutionized the field of mathematics in the early 20th century, contributing to algebra and mathematics of symmetry. She was appointed by mathematician and the teacher of Einstein himself, David Hilbert, to the University of Göttingen. Sadly, the faculty objected to this new entry. The time was of World War I, and many worried about what their brave men would say when they return and see a woman teaching mathematics to them, but she held on and taught under the name of Hilbert. She gave a theorem called Noether theorem, which proposes that behind every physical conservation law, there is associated physical and mathematical symmetry. This theorem led to the foundation of the conservation laws of charge that paved the way for quantum mechanics to be established later in that time. What are your thoughts about these unsung heroes in science? Let us know in the comments. If you found this video interesting, please leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Do follow us on Instagram for daily quality content that'll make you fall in love with science. Comment down the topics that you want us to cover in our next videos. Do check out other videos on our channel. Make sure you subscribe to the World of Science. Until next time, stay scientific.